What's up, YouTube? This is Vocal Citizen. This is Vocal Citizen React. How y'all doing? Okay, TJ Holly asked me to do this ring, and I just got done doing Wither, and my heart rate is still elevated from that fucking song. It's still elevated. Because it's got metal in it. So I'm doing this ring. I was only going to do a couple of Tech Nines today. This will be my fourth one. But I'm fucking doing this shit. If this fucking dude, straight out the gate, I did Faster with Dax, and I just did Wither, and now I'm doing this one. If this song is as impressive as those, might have to become like a full Tech Nine fan. Because Wither just blew my fucking mind. Oh. I'm gonna do the lyrics video because this dude spits so fucking fast it's hard for me to catch all the bars. So I am going to do the lyrics video. Hopefully the lyrics are spelled correctly. I'm at Vocal Citizen on Instagram and Twitter. Thanks for watching my channel. Like the video if you would, please. Unless you hate it, and then definitely dislike it because I don't like bullshit. I don't need your fucking pity likes. You hear what I'm saying? Subscribe to me if you want to. I'm the Vocal Citizen and I say what the fuck I want. So if you like real shit, unedited shit, low-tech shit, you're here for it. Let's go. Oh, I'm still worked up from the last fucking song. I'm still worked up. Takes me a minute to mellow out, okay? My life is pretty small, so when I get... All right. Let's go. A lot of da-das. A lot of da-das. Come on. Blow my mind. Let's go.
Go. You take this man to be your lawfully wedded husband. His sickness and his health. For richer or for poorer. For better or for worse. For death do you part.
I do.
Do you take this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife. His sickness and in health. For richer or for poorer. For better or for worse. Till death do you part.
Of a patriot. I often fear that my sins and my past might come back to haunt me. But the consequences are more than I can bear. I feel that shame. This piece right.
Don't freak out, I am going to go back because I like to hear all the bars, but I'm going to nitpick this once and then I'll shut the fuck up about it. Consequences is spelled wrong. More than I can bear, that means naked. B-E-A-R means to bear something. I'm just fucking saying. If you're gonna do a fucking lyrics video, spell shit right. Okay? Because there are OCD bitches like me out there in the world whose fucking brains are gonna melt. Because you don't know how to spell shit. It does a disservice to Tech Nine because I promise he doesn't spell the shit wrong. I'm gonna back it up. Don't freak out. Had to do it. I'm OCD. You'll learn. This is your first Vocal Citizen video. You will understand that I nitpick shit. It's what I do.
Consequences are more than I can bear. I feel that shame. This piece right here is about what comes with fame.
Okay.
And the struggle to keep family within fame. I give you this ring.
Okay.
This ring. Got me a top knot, straight hot fox. We shot rocks in the Ewok slot. Was caught, got dropped to playing hopscotch on the block. Ought not twat plot. If I hop, not a broad dot. This ring. Remain sane, no game games came from bang to a change main. No pain thing, refrain from gang bang, slang a brain rains, family fame, then came pain.
Hello, Tech Nine. What the fuck with the rhyme scheme, dude? Help me remain sane, no name games. He playing, doing that Eminem shit, playing with the pronunciation of the word to make it fit in the rhyme scheme, but I'm here for it. No cane thing, refrain from gang bang. And it just keeps going. Fucking, I appreciate brilliant fucking rhyme schemes. That's playful. It's delicious. It's fucking yummy. I'm here for it. Nice vibe. Nice vibe. His voice is nice. Backing it up just a little bit.
Rains, family, fame, then came pain.
Say hello to Tech Nine.
Everybody wanna be down with a nigga when we get away with the money, thinking of taking it from me. They get up in the club, giving the love, throwing the pussy full of liquor and bug. Booty hopping around up in the mode, get to looking around every hole when I look a nigga low. Infatuated with niggas with dough. Give me a second, try to make them let it go.
Lick them low.
Bitches in front of rapping niggas who think of having pickets, they get to grab them, shoot it, they can imagine villains when they come back and get us wicked to back and niggas.
Alright. Women who go after men for their money are fucked up. Go earn your own shit, bitch. And make him come after your money and shit. That's bullshit. I love the usage of the word twat. I'm gonna say this. This video is not appropriate for people under the age of 13 years old, and it's marked as so on YouTube, so I'm just gonna say this. Twat is one of my favorite fucking words. Don't like the word pussy. Ew. Semen fiend or fiend semen, however he said it. Okay, but if he puts the word cunt in here, I'm gonna be done for the day, because that's my favorite word. It's my favorite word. It's my favorite word. I like the fact that he's not afraid to use terms that are, most women are like, what? Yeah, I fucking love it. I fucking love it. Gonna back it up, because I don't like to miss bars. And G-strings, I used to wear those when I was in my 20s. Those hurt. Thongs are better. Okay. That was awesome. Is it over? Okay. This way brings the meaning, demons, and G-strings. We sing, make them fiends, singing in green things. Clean getting dreams and thinking of being misplaced. But this way, if I wasn't Jack Knight, bitches wouldn't even want to be with Jack Knight. If I did no music, then would you respect mine? This wedding band and music draws a line between life and Jack Knight. Jack Knight. Crazy J told me superstars are good providers, but 2 times out of 10 when we on tour, family's not beside us. What can a nigga do when he make ends? Add more to the time they spend. While they make ends, everything else break in, and the bond of the house may end. And your wife, he's steady yelling by quality time. And you think with all the fame and fortune, shit ought to be fine. But what happens when the divorce papers just gotta be signed? And you lose half and your children, cause you gotta be 9. I wanna relax with them and spend time to the maximum. But if silence is golden, then me making noise is platinum. I gotta be tech and daddy and hubby, but music, women, mixed with families, ugly. I know when you know that hella be hot for a nigga's infidelity. But until then, God forgive me for any promises that I broke. Family can be forgiven for all the liquor and weed that I smoke. When I succeed, will I cut? Will I still breathe without both? This ring, Tech Nine? I don't know, but when I go, I'm leaving out dough. This ring. I love this part. Wow. Ooh. Fuck. Now I'm a Tech Nine fan. I let the video play all the way out. Chill. part of his art. I gotta let it finish. Okay, and just all of a sudden cut off. Dude, that was fucking rad. That was rad. And I'm gonna say this right now. I'm not gonna go into a big long story. I'm just gonna say, I have been in love twice in my life. And the first time I got married and I like made a person and she's grown now and she's fabulous. And my ex-husband and I mutually decided to get divorced. I didn't sue him for child support. I didn't sue him for alimony. He just paid child support because that's his kid and it's an obvious thing to do. So it wasn't court ordered or nothing. So we had a nice divorce and we're still really great friends. The second one, he was a musician and we ended up breaking up for stupid reasons. We were in our mid-20s and then he married somebody else. She first met him, I promise there's a point to this story. When she very first saw him, he was on a stage in front of thousands of people singing. Good singer, he was a very talented musician. Had his band, they were doing well, starting to get some label interest, that kind of thing. Yada yada, fast forward, that's how she met him, was looking up on a stage and falling in love with the lead singer, okay? Fast forward to a couple years later, they're married. As soon as they got married, she started to mock his dream. I can't believe you want to be a rock star, you know, you're married now. Excuse me, you married a fucking performer. So when he was talking in there about he was hoping that the fame and the fortune was, you know, the wife complaining about quality, oh, it's right there. And your wife, he's steady yelling about quality time and you think with all the fame and fortune shit ought to be fine. If you marry a musician and you know they're a musician, if you marry a firefighter, if you marry a doctor who works 100 hours a week, you can't bitch about, once you're married, you cannot bitch about not having quality time. You can't bitch about that shit. You knew who the person was when you married him or her, whichever way it goes. It's fucking bullshit to steal somebody's dream away from them because you got a fucking ring on your finger. That doesn't entitle you to just claim their whole fucking life and all their shit. So Tech N9ne, I don't know if this is true or not. Somebody tell me down in the comments if that actually happened to him, like he got married and the woman started bitching. You don't spend enough time with me. Hello, you fucking knew I was a performer when you met me. And if I became a performer after we met, we should have talked about it before I got into the shit. Don't bitch about what I do. If you don't fit into my life, if I don't fit into your life, then we shouldn't get married. Oh, so fucking stupid. It's wretched, absolutely wretched to fuck somebody's dream over because you're like, well, we're married now, your whole life is over and you gotta do what I say you gotta do, that's fucked. And honey, if Tech N9ne, good looking man, I'm gonna say it, he's a good looking dude. I don't care if he's got 8 cents in his bank account. If I were still in the dating mode, I'd be all over that shit. I can tell you that right now, money or not, fame or not, doesn't matter. It's a good song, it was a good song. Thank you for requesting it. That's 2 requests I've done for you now. Okay? I have to look at your name again because, look at my fucking list, dude. It's fucking crazy. Each one of those are fucking songs that I'm hopefully doing today. So let's see who you are. TJ Holly 1226. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the reaction. 14 fucking minutes. Don't care. It's implied in my name that I fucking talk a lot. If you didn't realize that, you need to pay attention to the fucking name of the channel. Hope you guys liked it. Subscribe. Bye.